Hi, I'm Mariana from Mailchimp. In this video, I'll show you how to design and customize your pop-up form to match your brand. You'll learn how to upload your logo, change fonts and colors, and add other eye-catching elements to engage your audience. To get started, head to Forms and you'll be dropped into the new pop-up form dashboard. Next, click Create Pop-up Form and pick your template. Take note, many anticipate a card-style modal. However, our templates often utilize a full-page format, which converts better. For a card-style implementation, select templates with a design that occupies a discrete portion of the screen, such as a centered card or a slide-out. For our demo, we'll choose this warm split pop-up form and click Apply. For the next couple of steps, you'll name your form and select whether you'd like to collect emails and SMS phone numbers. If your audience is SMS-enabled, then click Create Form to move to the design step. This builder is designed to be a mobile-first editing tool, meaning you should always make your design changes on the mobile viewport first. Then you can update the desktop view as needed. This approach streamlines the design process, as desktop modifications will not translate to the mobile version. On the left, the sequential steps are delineated for easy navigation. Selecting a step will direct you to the corresponding element within the design. The canvas can be navigated using the scroll function, and the zoom can be adjusted via the zoom tool. While individual steps can be removed, it's generally advised to retain all steps. The removal of the offer step in particular is discouraged. Actually, from years of testing, we know that its presence tends to improve conversion rates. On the right, you'll find a bulk editing panel displaying the fonts and colors utilized within this design. Modifying the hue of the current color to this one will globally update all instances of that color throughout the form. Let's move to the background color options. The overall background color can be modified to a different color, affecting all steps due to linked styles. Remember, it's important to set the new background color's opacity to at least 97%, that way the website is still visible behind the pop-up. The teardrop icon indicates a linked style. Though this is not recommended, you can detach a style if you need to make an adjustment to one specific step. This feature offers an efficient method for implementing design changes. The same functionality extends to font changes. If you have a logo present in your Mailchimp brand kit, that logo will automatically be pulled into the design. Otherwise, you can manually upload your logo on the right side panel by clicking Replace from Brand Kit, and you can add a new logo there. This is also where you can swap for a different version of your logo if needed, depending on the colors used in your form. If you need to adjust the size of the logo, you can increase or decrease the width in the position section. One great thing about our new tool is how customizable it is. You can even change the shape and style of the input field or buttons to match your brand. To do so, select an element on the canvas, and the corresponding properties will appear in the properties panel on the right. For example, selecting an input field or button will display properties such as padding and rounded corners. Modifying a linked style, such as the rounded corners, will affect all elements using that style. For image customization, templates often utilize an image background component that functions similarly to a standard image element. You may need to update the images on both mobile and desktop separately, but start with mobile. For example, to change an image background, click the one you'd like to work with. In the image background section, click Replace Image to upload your brand imagery. You can also remove background and autocrop, or remove background only. Now you can adjust the size, set a repeat pattern, or choose the alignment of that background. If an image appears misaligned or ill-fitting after the replacement, you can adjust the alignment and positioning settings. Options include left-right alignment and vertical positioning. The cover setting may restrict certain adjustments. The contain setting ensures the image fills the entire space, while custom allows for specific width and height ratio selections. Ultimately, the optimal settings depend on the specific image chosen, and we recommend choosing an image that best fits the container shape and size already set, but these options provide control over the image's presentation if adjustments are needed. Moving on, you can alter the copy in your template by clicking any of the text elements and updating them based on your specific offer. For this example, let's double-click on the text container and change the copy to ask customers what their favorite ice cream flavor is. Let's set our buttons to give our customers their different options for ice cream flavors. We'll have to map button elements to specific audience fields or groups. So let's click on the button and navigate to Button Actions. new audience fields or groups can be created via the Manage Audience Fields option, which redirects to the audience settings. If you're using one of our mini quiz templates, we recommend setting the user property to groups and utilizing a group already present in your MailChimp account. For example, you can map a button to the favorite ice cream group with predefined values like strawberry, chocolate, and vanilla. If you need to create a new group, you can click Manage Groups, Create New Group, and select the type of group you'd like to use in your signup form. Checkboxes are the most common, but radio buttons and dropdowns are also available. The value will be automatically set as the text inside of the button unless you choose to untoggle Use Value as Text and manually change the copy. Later on, let's say you would like to send a campaign specifically to customers who love chocolate ice cream. You can easily segment the subscribers who selected chocolate in the pop-up form so they can receive the most personalized content from you. If you'd like to capture any additional information about your customer, like their name, you can easily drag that specific type of user input container to capture that information. We recommend keeping the first step of your pop-up form simple for your users and adding input fields only to the following steps in the pop-up experience. To add a new input field, click Add an Element and select User Input and drag in the desired field, such as first name. Remember that this action must be performed in the mobile view. Once you've pulled in any additional input you'd like to collect, make sure that you then link that to a merge field in your MailChimp audience. To delete any elements of the design, simply click on that element in the design and press the Delete key or right-click on the element to delete, copy, or paste. To undo any changes, use Ctrl or Command plus Z or the undo arrow in the top bar. When using the Layers panel, be mindful of the selected layer, which will be highlighted in blue. Clicking on the primary CTA will display its properties, while clicking on the text with the CTA will display text-specific properties. Let's review the follow-up step. The follow-up step appears when you close the pop-up on any step. When a user clicks on the follow-up button, the pop-up will resume at the step where it was last closed. It is recommended to primarily modify the color or text of the follow-up button, as the underlying button action logic is pre-configured. If there are any errors to address before publishing, you will see them flagged inside of the builder. The last step in the pop-up template will be your confirmation step. Here you can set up a discount code, link to a downloadable or URL redirect, or direct your customers on the next action they need to take to become fully subscribed to your list. In this example, we're asking customers to reply Y to an automated text to redeem free shipping, since their SMS list is set to double opt-in. If you're utilizing a template with a discount code and come across any discount code errors, check both the last step and the follow-up to make sure you have the discount code configured on both, and make sure you're working on the mobile viewport. If you're offering a free guide download, configure the button action to go to URL and input the download link. If you're not offering any sort of incentive and just using a general newsletter signup, this last step can be where you confirm to customers that they are now subscribed to your list. Great work! Now that you've designed your pop-up form, review your settings and preview your design by navigating to Preview. Previewing locally will take a screenshot of your connected site and lay the pop-up on top of it. Previewing live will lay your pop-up on top of your currently active site. The pop-up is completely interactive in both options, so you can test each step. If you're happy with your design, click Save and Review to look over your pop-up form checklist. In the checklist section, you will first select which connected site you'd like your pop-up to show on. If you need to add a new site, you can do that by navigating to Manage Sites and connect to another one. Your form will default to appear on all pages of your website. You can add or exclude pages and adjust the conditions to match the needs of your site. For example, if we'd like to exclude the form from showing on our checkout page, we could update the rule to Currently Viewing Page URL that does not contain and add in /checkout and click Enter to block that page out. Then click Save. Default targeting of new visitors is recommended for optimal lead capture. While custom targeting rules can be added, this is considered an advanced feature. Some examples of advanced targeting could be setting geolocation, number of page views, or the traffic source the customer is coming from. When you're ready, click Publish or Schedule to publish your pop-up form on your website. Publishing now will immediately display on your site. Scheduling will allow you to select a start and stop date for when your form is live. And if you have more questions about your pop-up forms, visit MailChimp.com/help.